I'm shooting my shot.
My shot.
Shot my way to the top.
It won't stop.
I'm shooting my shot.
Hi guys, welcome to my channel, Empress Lika. And today I'm going to be giving my top tips for dyeing your locks. So my very first tip is to go to a professional, okay? If you don't know what you're doing and you have the option to go to a professional, go to a professional. Okay, my second tip is, if you don't want to go to a professional, I mean, I get it. I'm very particular about who touches my locks. I set my locks, I maintain them, and I don't let anyone just put their hands in my locks. Like, I'm very particular about that. So if you're like me, I get that. There's no judgment. But if you want to do it on your own, I highly recommend that you do your research. Like, that's my second tip. Do your research. Know the things that you need to do. Know the steps you need to take, the order that you need to take them in. Know all the products that you need to use. Things like that. For example, with me, when I first dyed my locks, I was very unhappy, okay, because I wanted this blonde look, and that's not what I got. What I got was like some cheetah patchy kind of color, and it kind of worked out in the end, but I really wasn't happy in the beginning, and I feel like that's because I didn't do my proper research. I skipped the whole toning stage, like the whole toning step. I completely skipped it and was just like, okay, let me just mix up this powder and this volume developer and bleach this hair, and that was a really big mistake. So make sure you do your research. Know if your hair needs to be previously washed or not. Some people believe that the dirtier the hair is the better, but I mean, it's just different things that you really want to make sure you know when you are dyeing your hair. So do your research. My third tip is to make sure you have enough product. This tip is very important because, again, something I had to learn the hard way from. I didn't have enough product, and because of that, the back of my hair up here in this area, it was really black still, and I just had to go with it. It just had to be like, okay, this is kind of what I'm going for, because the time I ordered my dye as a kit, I can't remember what the name is. It's like Extreme or something like that, but I'll leave the link below, because by the time I'm done with this video, I'll remember. So I'll put the link below. But I only got 2 boxes of it, and I do have pretty long hair, so I'm thinking, okay, this is more than enough. And by the time I was through that second one, I didn't have enough, and so I just had to make it work because I didn't want to go through the process of bleaching my hair again. I was really nervous that I've already did too much, and I was nervous that my locks was going to fall out again. This is why I say just go to a professional if you can, because it can be a nerve-wracking process. Because I mean, when I heard that pop and sizzle going on, I was like, yes, some locks are going to be coming out. I just feel it. I felt it. But luckily, no locks didn't come out, and I'm grateful. But this is why I also want to do this video, so any of you watching this don't have to go through the same mistakes that I went through, because sometimes if you leave it in too long or you do little things that mess it up, you can end up losing your locks, and we don't want that. Okay? So that was my third tip, which is to make sure you have enough product. My fourth tip is to make sure you know how to maintain your hair after you bleach it. So one of the things that I learned after bleaching my hair is that it's extremely dry all the time. It is dry all the time. And not only is it dry, I gotta be honest, y'all, the bleach damaged my hair. And in retrospect, I wish I didn't do it. Okay, I like the color, because don't get me wrong, I felt like I needed something different. I wanted something different so bad. I've never bleached my hair my whole life, so I really wanted to change, but I noticed damage to my hair because of the bleach. So I noticed that my hair was extremely drier, thinner. Some areas, I can't really, it's kind of hard to see now because it's in a braid out, but little dents, like this area, you can tell it's really red hair. So this area might have, for some weird reason, had too much bleach, and it's like a dent there. It's some locks that are feeling real questionable right now because they're feeling really thin. And I know that's just because of the bleach and how I did the process. I didn't do it correctly. I literally just mixed up some stuff and put it in my hair, and I just don't try to do that. Please don't do that, please. But if you do that, please know that once you're done, how you treat your hair moving forward is very important. So first things first is you need to get a good regimen. Something that is going to hydrate the hair and also seal in the moisture. For me personally, I love a good aloe gel. I love a good rose water spritz. And I love to seal it in with some castor oil. If you follow me on Instagram at Empress Lika, you know I'm a huge castor oil advocate. I love castor oil, castor oil, castor oil. Like, da-da-da-da-da-da, castor oil, castor oil, castor oil. Like, that's me, because I love castor oil. I live by it because it's actually helped my hair so much. It's helped my hair become thicker. It's helped seal in moisture. I love castor oil. Just give it a try. I mean, everyone's scalp is different, so if you feel like castor oil is not for you, fine. There are other oils that can seal in that moisture, but it's very important that you get a very strong regimen for sealing in that moisture and keeping your hair hydrated, because it will be dry all the time. My hair can be very coarse now. I just feel like bleaching my hair changed the texture of my hair some. Like, the texture is just not the same. It's just rougher and tougher, and it's just not as soft, and it was really soft and very lightweight feeling before I bleached it, and now it's just really dry all the time, and I'm constantly having to moisturize it. But on the good side, the more you moisturize, the more your hair will grow. So that's the good thing. But you have to get a good regimen, because if you do not get a good regimen, your hair will suffer. So you have to get a good regimen, and you have to stick with it. Be consistent with it. Don't like fall off, because your hair will show you that it needs that you to get back on top of it. Like, stick with it, okay? And my last and final tip is, do not go back and re-bleach it by a certain amount of time. Of course, I've read that you can, you know, like, oh, you can bleach it again, but I'm just telling you from my personal experience, give it some time, because I was so unhappy with my color that I was considering re-bleaching it like in a couple days, and something in my spirit was like, maybe my antennas, they was like, no, don't do that. They was like, don't do that, don't do it, it's not gonna be good for all of us, and they know it's not gonna be good for me and them, because I'm gonna be sad. I'm gonna be very, very sad. And I think they knew that. So something was just like, do not redo it. Even though I was reading online, like, oh, technically you can. I'm reading like, oh, you know, locks are really strong, they can take it. And I just was like, I don't know. I don't think I should do that. So I didn't. And instead, I just stuck with the color. I stuck with it. I made it work. People seemed to like it and thought it was what I meant to get. So I just kind of ran with it and kept it for a while. So my last tip is, do not re-bleach the hair if you're not satisfied immediately. Like, you can re-bleach it, but give it some time. Give it some time to catch itself, because you don't want to go and put those harsh chemicals back on your hair right after that. Now, I said that was my last tip, but that was my last tip because, honestly, recently I found out that you do not have to use bleach to dye your hair. So, I mean, this is my last tip, but it's technically should have been my first tip. But I need to go through these other tips first. But I recently learned that you don't have to dye your hair to get the color you want. One time I was in, okay, a little quick story time. I was in the store, and this lady was like, oh, your hair is so pretty. And I was like, thank you. She had beautiful hair too. And she was like, and I was like, your hair is so beautiful too. I love the color, you know, just beautiful. And she was like, thank you so much. I used to have locks. And she was like, you know, you don't have to bleach your hair for that. And I was like, what you mean? I don't have to bleach my hair, because I mean, I really would like to do color again, but in my mind, I already decided, like, yeah, I'm not putting my hair through this again. You're just gonna be black, okay? You're gonna be black for the rest of the life, for the rest of my life, or at least for like the next 8 years, because you need to recover from this bleaching. And she was like, now mind you, her hair was red too, and it was really pretty. And so she was like, yeah, you don't have to re-bleach your hair. And I was like, what you mean? And so she told me about this product called High Color. And I think it's High Color, like HICOLOR. I will put a link in the description below for you guys as well. And she was like, yeah, you don't need to use bleach for that. And I looked it up, and I seen that there's videos of people who got highlights, a woman who did tips on her locks, and you don't use bleach. You just use that product with a 30 developer, mix it up. Okay, don't quote me on the process, because I don't know what the process is like, but I will find out, because I am going to try it after I go black for a while, because I'm going back to black for a while, but after I go back to black for a while, I am going to try it. But yeah, so if you really want to skip all those steps, you can skip all them steps and go ahead and try out this High Color product. Now, don't hold me to that quite yet, because I haven't tried it out, which is probably why I didn't start it as my first tip. Because I didn't want to give a tip and you guys go try it. It's like, it's not doing what it was supposed to do. And I didn't want to do that. But I will try it out myself after I go back to black for a while. And I will definitely do a video on that as well. But just definitely check that out as well. Do your own research. It's called High Color. It's from L'Oreal. I believe they have blonde, red. And just see. Try it out. do your research on it and see if it's something that can be a better alternative to you than the bleach, because my last and final tip is to avoid the bleach if you can. Okay, if you can just avoid the bleach, avoid it. But I get it. I did clays for a long time and it was really messy. I was done with the clays. I couldn't do the clays no more, okay? So I get it. And after I did the clays, I think I wanted more color even more. I just wanted something more permanent than that clay even more. So if you're yearning for a different color, I get it completely, because I've been there, done that. But if you can find a safer way to change your hair color without using the bleach, definitely do that. And that's my final tip. So thank you for watching. If you stay to the end, I appreciate you. If you like this video, hit that subscribe button and follow me on Instagram for more content like this. Thanks for watching again. I'm shooting my shot, but I know I can't miss it. I'm shooting my shot like a man.